हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, तो टुडे वी विल बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग द कंसेप्ट ऑफ स्विच केस, हाउ स्विच केस वर्क्स। स्विच केस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ कंडीशनल ब्रांचिंग इन सी। सो स्विच केस अलाउज यू टू सिलेक्ट दैट विच पर्टिकुलर कंडीशन डू यू वांट टू एंटर इनटू एंड विच डेटा यू कैन एंटर इनटू विच कंडीशन एंड व्हाट टाइप ऑफ रिजल्ट यू मे गेन। सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द स्विच केस by creating a calculator using the switch case. Thus, this particular calculator would be performing addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay, so let's start with it. So, what conditions we want our calculator to perform? The calculator should perform addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay, so these four functions will be performed by a calculator of the switch case. Okay, so we will be including our header files, include stdio.h, include conio.h, void main. The main is the execution point of any C program. Now we will be getting the values from the user on which we want to perform the operation. So we are taking integer values, supposedly A and B, and answer in which the values will be stored after performing operation. Now we will be taking clear screen, CLRSCR. Then we will be asking values from the user. For A and B. Okay. Now we will be storing that values into our variables A and B. The format specifier used over here will be percentage %t, as it is integer data type. Ampersand A comma ampersand B. Okay, now once we got the values, after that we would be having to take one more variable, that is choice. This choice variable will help us to select that which particular condition we want to fulfill through our this program. So we will be then asking user to enter the choice. So enter choice, one for addition, two for subtraction, three for multiplication, and four for division. Okay, so these are the four choices which user has to enter from. Now we will be taking that choice from the user. It is percentage %t as integer variable and percent choice. Okay, so we have taken the choice from the user. This choice will help us to move further with the switch case, as we will be creating a switch case over here by writing the keyword switch, and in bracket we will write choice. So whatever will be the choice, whatever will be the number of the choice, that case from the switch block would be executed. So we are creating now cases. Case one is for addition. So what are we doing? Answer is equal to A plus B. Okay, now we'll be printing the answer. Addition is percentage %t comma ampersand answer. Okay, so my case one is over, my addition is over, so I'll have to mention break over here, else it will move further in another cases, but we want to execute the case with a particular choice only. Now we'll be having case 2. Okay, so same thing, case 2 is for subtraction. So a minus b. Printf subtraction is percentage d comma ampersand answer. Here there will be double quotes will be ending. If we do not need to add ampersand in printf statement, because if we add ampersand in the printf statement, we will be able to print the address value of that particular variable. So we won't print address, so we won't be writing ampersand. Now comes answer is equal to a into b. So that is the multiplication, and we will be printing the same. So multiplication is percentage b comma a n s. Okay, so now my multiplication answer is printed. See, we need to mention break statement after every case is over, so that it does not enter into any other case after its work is over. Now my case 4 would be the division case. So answer is equal to a divided by b. Printf division would be percentage d, okay, comma ans answer. We'll be adding the break statement. Now my all the four cases are over. What if I enter 5 in the choice variable? So we need some default case that lets us know that we have entered a wrong choice. So for that, we need to create a default case that lets us know that we have entered a wrong choice and none of the case matches that choice. That means when you enter the value that does not match case 1, case 2, case 3, case 4, then it will by default go into the default value. So now we'll be writing our getch. Okay, so here is our switch case that is ready to be executed. So first of all, we will be saving it. Is a calculator using switch. Okay, so we have saved it. Now we would be compiling it to check any errors. There are no errors. Now we will be running it. Now supposedly I had value of a is 4 and b is 2. So now I have to enter the choice whether I want to do addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. Suppose I want to do multiplication, so my multiplication is 8. The same way we can run the program again. Now I'm writing my a is 6, b is 3, and I want to divide it, so my division is 2. Okay, so my cases are working. Now supposingly I'm entering a is 4, b is 2, and I am writing 5. So though it is written that choice should be between 1, 2, 3, 4, supposingly I am adding the input as 5, then it will let me know that you have entered a wrong choice. That means none of the operation can be performed over it. So this is how basically switch case work on the condition through which we want to execute the program. Okay, thank you so much, everyone.